J-Boy shiners, look at my homies. Got a quarter bricky up in my Louis bag of that Calvin Brodus. Dog. Dog food, counting up all blues, step back, I pony. Walking hush, then drop 200K just to match my roller, yeah.
Know what I'm saying? I don't know whoever Mike Wavy TV is, know what I'm saying? Shout out to them, know what I'm saying? I'm about to use some of your audio and all that, know what I'm saying? Watch this, y'all. Watch this. It's enough. He got a call from prison.
What?
Call for prison? All right, hold on. Y'all heard that? Oh, QC said, not too clear? I'm running back. No J2. I know, say that's mad J2. That's a fact. Know what I'm saying? We gotta get down to the bottom of this, know what I'm saying? Pause. No J2. At bottom. Pause at bottom. Hold on, let's run it back. Now I'm saying, hold on, listen up. I should have used a string, y'all. Hold on, y'all. Listen up, y'all. Listen up, everybody. Shh. I-Penny, shut up. Shut up in the background, I-Penny. Shh. T-Bull, hold it down, T-Bull. No vital fly. Hold it down. Listen up, y'all. Unknown. Listen.
Hey,
I don't even want to play. I don't want to play no more. Y'all heard that? Nigga said he wanted to do what with his stomach? What? And nigga did about like 4 months. Hey, yo. Hold on. Know what I'm saying? Shout out to the cellmate and all that, know what I'm saying? He gonna call up the tooth and all that, know what I'm saying? We waiting for his call, y'all. Hold on, y'all. Let's run it back one more time.
Blue Magneto, hold it down for me because I got a call from prison.
Me too. No, J2.
What it do, man? It's your boy Babble Truth coming to you live and direct from the Babble Truth headquarters. Let's get right off into this. So this dude is out of his league. He messing with the wrong one. He's so used to coming at cats who he know don't have channels that can't match his energy, and battle rappers who really overlook a lot of things. He really believe and he can do that to me. Dog, you out of your league. And I'm going to just show you how you out of your league, how it's so easy to just do you like this. I'm going to embarrass you addressing your little Chucky doll without even addressing the real man who you are, Dwayne Parks. We're going to get to that in a later day. Right now, I'm just going to show you how I can break you down. Being this doll that you put your spirit inside of. I'm gonna do something you can't do. I'm gonna show you the difference between me and you. I'm gonna break you down emotionally. I'm going to roast the hell out of you at the same time, and I'm going to do it effortlessly. Effortlessly. Okay? Welcome. You the next person up on my kill shot list. And this ain't even a kill shot. Wait till I get to that stuff, if I decide to. You already down one zip. This going to be two zip. You're not going to win a round in this, brother. Trust me. I can go longer than you. I can go longer than you. I can do more than you. And I'm more aggressive than you. Let's get some things out of the way you can't compete with me on. This battle rap blog and stuff, you can't compete with me on. You want to go through numbers? You want to go through subscribers? You'll lose easily. Easily. I ain't going to even get to that yet. You want to put money up involved in this? I make way more money than you. Outside of battle rap and in battle rap, you're going to lose that argument. You want to go even a little deeper? Show your house. I show my house. Let's see who got the most. Let's see. See, any way you want to do this, you're going to lose this. You want to go on what's real out here, what's normal out here? Let's do that too. You're going to lose on that too. I'm finna just destroy your dial. Now that every time somebody see your dial, they're going to be reminded of what I did to it. So I'm going to destroy your tool, then I'm going to destroy the man. See the difference between us? See, here's something about you to just show how fake you is and how you just a weak, lame sucker. All you're going to do is try to repackage what everybody else then said and done, like you're doing now, which actually destroyed you. Did you not know that this blog you just did destroyed you? I'm going to show it to you. Don't even worry about it, okay? Now, you call yourself making up something to try to make me look bad or to expose me, but you can't, because in the same blog that you plan, you actually proving me. In the same time you plan this, you actually exposing you. You proving me to be true, but exposing you to be false. And we finna get off into that. Your own blog just blew your damn brains out. So let's get off into the Dwayne Parks, because that's your real name. I know about some things. That's gonna come in a later day. Right now, let me just tell you up on your own stuff. Now, so he did a blog. He ain't even funny. This dude don't got no talent at all. That's why he keep repeating the same things all the time. This dude is lame. I'm going to show him this is the battle you will never win, okay? I'm going to show him something. Now, with that being said, this clown, this dog, he actually did a video trying to say he was having a conversation with my so-called cellmate. He was talking to a real homosexual that he personally know. This is an associate of his, a personal associate of his. This is how retarded and stupid this nigga is. But in the midst of this interview, they slip up so many times, they actually tell him that they in a relationship with each other. Oh yeah, we gonna get off into this. And let me tell you something else, Dwayne Parks. I have a video on you getting your butt filled on as the real person you are. Yeah, we got a video on that too, which makes this video makes more sense of what's going on. Oh yeah. You've been found out. Oh, you've been found out. Let's go a little deeper though. So, he called himself trying to expose me. But in the same video he trying to expose me on, it actually proved my whole point of what's going on. Now, let me just show you how fake niggas is. So he speaking as if he talking to my ex-cellmate, which is a real homosexual. He know. Y'all got to pay attention, y'all, as I play this and walk y'all through this as they tell on each other. So this is the person he personally know. This is not real at all on my behalf. This is real on his behalf because this is something he made up. But he's trying to use words I said, twist them up, cut and clip them to make it appear like I'm saying something that I'm not saying so that he could bring shame to me. So in this clip, he play, let's pay attention how this clip destroys him. Listen, watch this.
He gonna call up the 2-4-0 like I'm saying. We ain't for his call, y'all. Oh, Hold on, y'all. Let's run it back one more time.
He got a call from prison.
Link to? No, link to?
Okay, now remember, so look what he did. So he took clips of my videos and made a whole thing. So he took a clip for when I was live and I got a prison call coming through while I was live. I got a couple nephews that locked up in prison. I got a couple cousins that locked up in prison and a couple of my guys locked up in prison. But that was my nephew actually calling from prison. So while I was live, the call comes through and I tell one of my supporters, hey, take over the show while I answer this call from prison. So then they took that and clipped that out. Then they took the other clip when, now I want to show you just how demonic and wicked these dudes is and why they cursed. Why they cursed. And see, they don't know. You're talking to the wrong person. Trying to come up against me ain't going to work out good for you. These bring curses on your life. And I'm going to show you something. So he take a clip of me saying, I remember when I was in prison, when I was 18 years old, right? I had a homosexual cellie. Then a thought came to my head, get you some head. But listen to the clip. It said, I immediately shut that thought down out of my head. Then they cut it off. Because I go on to say, because I knew it was of the devil. What was the purpose of me saying that? I got a call from a Christian brother of mine asking me, could I speak to this girl who he knew? Because she was finna kill herself. In the process of this girl finna kill herself because she felt her life had no value, no worth, and nothing else was worth living for, she was finna kill herself. And in desperation, he called me, who was more spiritual and more experienced in the situation, to help the young lady out. When I get on the phone with the young lady, I'm talking to the young lady, I'm trying to calm her down. By me being old and experienced, I began to tell the young lady, listen, these thoughts you're hearing in your head to kill yourself, do not listen to it. Do not submit to those thoughts. That's nothing but the devil trying to destroy you. People may have hurt you in your life. You may feel that people don't even love you, but that's a lie. And I began to go into the things and telling her, the devil will attack us in our mind, but you have to know the difference between what's coming from you and what's of him. Anytime you're hearing something telling you to kill yourself and people gonna feel sorry when they find out you dead and they gonna wish they regretted what they did to you when they find out you died as a result of that, I'm like, they not gonna love you. They gonna go on with their life and say you was a damn fool and went out like a sucker. So I began to talk to the girl. Then I told the girl, I said, look, when I was 18 years old and I was in prison, surrounded by all that homosexuality that was going on in prison, a thought came to my head, you should get you some head. I knew immediately that that was the devil. I shot that thought down out of my head because I knew it was the devil. I found the common ground that the girl can relate on, that she could know that I understood and sympathized with the thoughts that she was hearing in her head to kill herself. But look at how unsympathetic these guys is to life, to something so serious as that, to use it as a form of mockery, to try to tear me down, to make it seem as though I'm a dirty, evil type dude. When in reality, I'm showing the truth of how the devil operates. Thoughts come through your head for the most part as a result of the environment you are around. Like again, for instance, I'm only talking to mature people and not these clowns who try to make a joke out of everything. For instance, like if you in a dope house, like I used to be in my dope house, surrounded by dope, then you hear thoughts out of nowhere, cause dope in front of you. You should take that. You should sniff that. You should see what I'm saying? You got to shut them thoughts down. Like, why are them damn thoughts coming in my head? Cause you around it. You in the environment. I remember at times I used to have my pistol on me. Then I just hit ideas like, you should go rob them niggas. You should shoot that nigga. Why? Because I got the pistol on me and that knowledge of what the pistol do, the devil use thoughts in your head and you always got to shut these things down. No different. The young lady understood what I was talking about. And to this day, the girl is alive. Glory to God. And she didn't take her life. But they use that to try to make it seem though I'm some type of homosexual, some stuff like that. When you clearly hear the tape saying, I immediately shut that thought down. Shut that thought down. Because I knew it didn't come from me. It came from the devil. Oh, nigga, I don't think like that, homie. You wasn't in the environment. You wasn't in the environment. And I don't think that way neither. That's why I said I immediately shut the thought down because I know them from the devil. But they leave all that out. That's what I mean by they clip and edit and put together to see they can make things say something. But it's okay though. That's why God continued to bless me as a result of these things, because he know the real truth and he know what y'all doing. That's why in y'all private life that this internet ain't picking up, I know y'all cursed financially, physically, mentally, spiritually. I know that because of things like this, but it's okay though. But as y'all can hear, it clearly says that I clearly shut the thought down. Listen, let's listen to it again. See that? I immediately cut that thought out of my head. The moment the devil put it there, I immediately shut it down. And keep in mind, I'm talking to a young lady that's about to kill herself because the voices she hearing in her head that's telling her to kill herself. Never mind. Let's listen to some more.
We gotta cut that short. You know what I'm saying? We got the cellmate calling. Hold on, y'all. Hello?
This is a prepaid call from
Cinnamon Hill, honey. Oh, shit. I'll accept
the call. County Correctional Facility. All phone calls are subject to recording and monitoring. To decline this call, press 9 now, and to accept this call, press 1 now.
I'm press 1.
Thank you. Your call has been accepted.
Oh, shit.
Thank you, honey.
What's the word, OG? King cellmate, what's the word, cellmate?
Oh, nothing, honey. After Brady has son. How your DNA tooth?
Shout out to you and all that, I'm saying. Let's cut it short right there. You won't cut out the honey, I'm saying. Don't call me honey, I'm saying. I got to ask you a couple questions, you heard?
I'm sorry, girlfriend.
Nah, no girlfriend. Call me Tooth, you heard?
Tooth.
Yeah, call me Tooth. Just Tooth, you heard? I gotta ask you a couple questions, I'm saying, about Gerard Baker. Are you familiar with Gerard Baker?
Oh, yes, honey. He was my cellmate for about 6 months, honey.
6 months? Hold on. Stop. Y'all was in the same cell for 6 months?
Oh, yes, girl.
So, hold on, one more question. Did he have the top bunk or the bottom bunk?
Oh, he was the bottom.
Oh, no. Wait, whoa. Pause. I said, I'm talking about the bands, the bunk bands. Did he have the top band or the bottom band, King?
I was more of the top, honey, but, we
would
switch it up sometimes.
Oh, wow. Hey, yo. All right, so I got a question, I'm saying. I know you're doing, I'm saying, a little time and all that. And I'm saying, just for confirmation, I'm saying, what was your name again, sir, miss?
My name is Cinnamon Toast, honey.
Cinnamon Toast?
Crunchy.
Hey, yo, I ain't never crunchy. Watch your mouth, you heard? And I'm saying, but hold on, I got a question to ask you. And I'm saying, before we get to Gerard Baker, and I'm saying, why they call you Cinnamon Toast Crunch? And I'm saying, if it's some pause worthy shit, don't say it, you heard? I'm trying to monetize.
Because I'm sweet, honey.
Hey, yo,
that's the...
Oh, because you're sweet. All right, that answers everything. And I'm saying, all right, so I don't know if you're familiar, and I'm saying, with Gerard Baker, and I'm saying his current activities outside, and I'm saying on the streets here, free man and all that, and I'm saying outside in a free world, and I'm saying Gerard Baker is also known as Battle Truth, and I'm saying he's a battle rap blogger, and I'm saying right now, and I'm saying he had a little story about you back in the day saying y'all had a little thing back in the cell and all that, and I'm saying you're trying to clear some things up, and I'm saying you want to speak on that?
Oh, yes, honey.
we had very hot nights. Very hot nights. He would beat me sometimes, but it was very hot.
Hold on, so he's beating you?
Yeah, sometimes he would beat me, honey, but you know, I'm a tough boy.
You a tough boy?
Very tough, honey.
Hey, yo, and I'm saying, so hold on. So you're trying to tell me right now, you confirming right now, Battle Tune Cellmate, a.k.a. Cinnamon Toast Crunch, a.k.a. Cinnamon Toast Crunchy, if you feel it crunchy. And I'm saying, you're trying to confirm right now that all those stories is true. And I'm saying that you actually had, and I'm saying, a little oral agreement, and I'm saying, was Jerome Baker?
Yes, I
mean. When I say oral agreement, I'm talking about, and I'm saying, the prison terms, yeah?
Whatever you wanted, honey.
Hey, yo. So hold on. You trying to say Battle Goof was in a part of cell? Jerome Baker was in a cell with you for 6 months and you turned him out?
He turned me out.
Honey. He turned. Oh, wait. So you trying to tell me before you went in the cell, you was a straight man?
Get back, bitch. I'm on the phone. Hello?
Oh, damn. Who that? That was your cellmate?
Yes, honey. Go ahead, ask me your question, honey.
Before you went to jail, you was a straight man?
Yeah, I was straight. I had a wife before I went to prison and met Gerard.
Oh, whoa, slow down. Time out. You just threw me through a loop. No J2, you know what I'm saying? No, pause. You trying to say you was a straight man before you went to jail, and as soon as you went to jail in 6 months, Jerron Baker turned you out?
Yes, honey.
Hey, yo! Go ahead.
Yes, honey, it was very musty nights. It was very good to me. I miss him very much, but he got out and he turned his life around, honey.
Yeah, right now you talking about he a Christian and all that. And I'm saying, was he preaching to God? And I'm saying, why he was in there? Or was he Muslim? So what was he praising? I'm saying, I know when niggas go to jail and all that, and I'm saying they turn Muslim and all that, and I'm saying, what was he praising to?
Only thing he prayed to was me, honey.
Hey, yo, on his knees? Hey, yo, and you giving up, and I'm saying a lot of information and all that, and I'm saying I got one more question before you go and all that, and I'm saying? And I'm saying, while Battle Goof was in jail, while Jerome Baker was in jail and all that, and I'm saying for 6 months, and I'm saying, what type of cellmate was he? And I'm saying, was he the type to wash the drawers and all that? And I'm saying, or was he the tough guy?
Oh, he was a cupcake, honey.
He was a cupcake?
He was a cupcake. Very sweet.
Oh, he was very sweet. You say he was sweet?
Very sweet, very nice man.
Damn.
Very good to me.
Damn. And I'm saying, I don't want to hold you up too long and all that. And I'm saying, I know you got a little, you want to box and all that. And I'm saying, you're doing 23-1 and all that. And I'm saying, you got a little hour of free time and all that. I don't want to hold you up, you heard?
Oh, no. Thank you, honey.
I appreciate your time. I hear you. My bad. Go ahead.
Thank you, DNA's
too. I appreciate your time and all that. And I'm saying, you heard, sis?
I'll talk to you later. Thank you.
All right, get back. I'm gonna tell Gerard to hit up your commissary. You heard?
Thank you, honey.
All right. Cinnamon rolls and all that. You heard? We gotta cut that short.
Okay, so this the so-called call from where my homosexual Sally supposed to be calling him, which is crazy, y'all, because remember, it's a lie on my behalf, but it's the truth in his real life. So this is a real homosexual that he personally know, who he gave heads up in doing this stuff. Watch how they start telling on each other. Watch this.
Sure, you know what I'm saying? We got the cellmate calling. Hold on, y'all. Hello?
This is a prepaid call from Cinnamon
Toast,
honey.
Oh, shit.
I'll accept the call. All phone calls are subject to recording and monitoring. To decline this call,
I'm pressing one.
Okay, look what he did. So he recorded somebody calling from a real prison. Notice what he did to try to be slick. When it was naming the prison, he talked through it so you couldn't hear the prison being mentioned, so it can prove that this is not real about me. So he used the prison thing to show it from a prison. But when the prison was finna be named to show where it's really at, because you can hear it and tell where it's really at, he talked through that part so you can't hear the name of the prison, thinking he slipped.
Thank you. Your call has been accepted.
Oh, shit.
Thank you, honey.
What's the word, OG? Can't
sell me. Hold on, wait. Let's hear this. Let's go back. Let's hear this. Pay attention.
Thank you. Your call has been accepted.
Oh, shit.
Thank you, honey.
See that? Hey, Tooth, honey. Ask yourself a question. How did this homosexual who supposed to be locked up get in contact with him? If he locked up, he definitely ain't got YouTube. He definitely ain't got access to the internet. How do this homosexual calling him from a correctional facility place know who he is? How? He already know who he is. How did he get your phone number? Who reached out and contacted him? Right. Keep that in mind, people. And keep in mind, this is a real homosexual who he know personally. Watch this. That just called him honey.
What's the word, OG?
See, he's trying to overtalk him because he know the tranny just called him honey. Look at that. Watch this. Watch when the tranny call him honey. See, he ain't too smart in the damn head itself. He didn't even know how to respond. So he like trying to, oh, damn, you just called me honey. Watch this. Pay attention, y'all.
Oh, shit.
Thank you, honey.
What's the word, OG? Can you sell me?
See that? Ain't nothing, honey. He talking to him. Notice the homosexual sweet talking him. This is his friend, his associate. But he's sweet talking him. Him. I could honestly say, and everybody listening know, I don't know the dude. Dude ain't even real in my life. He don't exist at all. But yet this is a real homosexual that he know, but he's sweet talking him. And keep in mind, this homosexual that's talking to him know him as a real person and not the Dow he's portraying to be. So this homosexual may be addressing the Dow, but he's actually addressing the man that's in the Dow, the man whose spirit is in the Dow, the man who's perpetrating in the Dow. Come on, let's go.
Yo, shout out to you and all that. And I'm saying, let's kind of shoot it right there. You won't cut out the honey. And I'm saying, don't call me honey.
See that? Now he training him. Now he's trying to lead him on. That's called leading a witness. He recording him. So he trying to bait him like, look, stop calling me honey. Stop calling me honey. This supposed to be about battle truth. So get back in character. You talking to me personally. See that? Oh, he gonna tell on himself throughout this whole thing. Oh yeah, we got Dwayne Parks. I understand. You've been exposed. You've been found out. That's what the Bible say. What the enemy meant for bad, did God take it and make it work for the good? Thank you for this video you just exposed yourself on. Let's listen to some more.
Call me honey. I'm saying I gotta ask you a couple questions. You heard?
Look, don't call me honey. See, he been sweet talking him through the whole thing. And keep in mind, this is his associate. that he know personally. They got each other real phone numbers. They got each other real phone numbers. What the Dow did, he took an audio clip that he put together and made it sound like a correctional facility, when in reality, the homosexual is already on the phone. He just trying to make it seem like it's one thing. No, it's two different things. He played the audio that he put together. Then when he got through playing that, he introduced the homosexual in. Watch this.
I'm sorry, girlfriend.
Nah, no, girl, no.
See that? I'm sorry, girlfriend. Steady coming at him. Steady coming at him. He didn't rehearse all that. Look, pretty sure he didn't rehearse all that part. The tranny is actually exposing him. Watch this.
Ayo, shout out to you and all that. And I'm saying, let's cut it short right there. You won't cut out the honey. And I'm saying, don't call me honey. And I'm saying, I gotta ask you a couple questions. You heard?
See that? He don't call me honey. I got a couple questions I need to ask you. In other words, stay in character. Stay in character. Let me ask you a couple questions. Stay in character. Watch the homosexual. See, here's the thing about these homosexuals. This is what this clown don't get, because he involved in it too deep. They can't control themselves. They can't help themselves. While you thinking you finna use him, he actually finna use you. He actually finna tell on y'all.
I'm sorry, girlfriend.
Nah, no girlfriend. Call me Toop, you heard? Yeah, call me Toop. Just Toop. Just Toop, you heard? I gotta ask you a couple questions, I'm saying, about Jerrod Baker. Are you familiar with Jerrod Baker?
About 6 months, honey.
See, okay. Now, he's steady sweet talking him. Even though he's steady telling him don't do it, he's steady doing it to him. Now he asked him, do he know about me? He said, I was his cellmate for 6 months. Okay. Here's the thing these clowns don't get. He wasn't my cellie for 6 months. So that, let's clear that up. He was my cellie doing what is called receiving. Not this guy he talking about, but the situation that I was speaking about when I was talking to the girl who was finna kill herself. The homosexual cellmate was my cellie for like 30 to 45 days. I forgot which one it was. He was there before me. He was stuck. He was stuck there in that place because, I think he had some type of health issue that was wrong with him. So he couldn't really leave out of that place. Me, I left after 30, 45 days when all my paperwork, blood work, all that stuff came back. So it was called receiving. Before you can go on population, you have to be tested to make sure you okay when they put you in population so nobody else could be affected if you had any type of diseases or something like that, right? So you only in receiving for 30 to 45 days unless something worse is wrong with you, right? So they already in error because they don't know nothing about prison. Watch this.
6 months? Hold on. So y'all was in the same cell for 6 months?
Oh, yes,
girl. So hold on.
Look, he's saying, yes, girl, hold on once. Anyway, get in there. Sit down. Okay, check this out.
One more question. Did he have the top bunk or the bottom bunk?
Oh, he was the bottom.
Oh, no.
Okay, now listen to that. Did I have the top bunk or the bottom bunk? And he says I was a bottom, talking about sexually. Watch this. Pay close attention.
Wait, whoa. Pause. I said I'm talking about the bands, the bunk bands. Then he had the top band on the bottom band, King.
I was more of the top
on
it, but we would switch it up sometimes.
Oh.
Okay, now he cleaned it up and said, no, I ain't talking about basically sexual, but was he on the top bunk or the bottom bunk? So he tried to land his premise to try to make this scene real by asking the homosexual, where was I sleeping? Was I on the top bunk or the bottom bunk? The homosexual, so damn dumb, he don't even understand prison, just like this clown don't understand prison. He says, sometimes I'll be on the top bunk, sometimes he'll be on the bottom bunk, and sometimes we'll switch it up. Sometimes I'll be on the bottom, sometimes he'll be on the top. Sometimes he'll be on the top bunk, sometimes I'll be on the bottom. So this homosexual he talking about has no knowledge of prison, just like this clown has no knowledge of prison. Why do I say that? Because anybody who been to prison or the county jails know you can't get on any bunk you want. You can't get on the top. You can't get on the bottom. You are assigned to a top or a bottom. And if you're not there, that's called unauthorized movement, where you can go to the hole as a result of false identification. Why? Because in prison and jail, your bed is also considered as a number. Like, for instance, they'll be like, Mr. Baker, top bunk. So the officers who change and shift and don't know you personally and all that stuff, all they know is Mr. Baker's on the top bunk or Mr. Baker's on the bottom bunk. So when they doing count and they see that you're not assigned to the bunk that you're supposed to be on, you can get in trouble for that. So ain't no, we'll change it up sometimes. See how stupid and dumb these are? It's easy to break these clowns down. It's easy to break these lying, fraudulent clowns down. But notice, the homosexual still ain't stopped calling him girlfriend, still ain't stopped calling him sweetie, because he know him personally. Even though he have warned him already 2-3 times, he's still doing it. Hold on, watch this. So this conversation he having with the tranny, he actually getting turned on by it. Watch this.
Ew, shout out to you and all that, and I'm saying, let's cut it short right there. You won't cut out the honey, you know what I'm saying? Don't call me honey. I gotta ask you a couple questions.
Now let's count how many times he keep calling him that, even though he just said, don't do it again. Watch this.
I'm sorry, girlfriend.
One.
No girlfriend. Call me Toop, you heard? Yeah, call me Toop. Just Toop, you heard? I gotta ask you a couple questions, you know what I'm saying, about Jerron Baker. Are you familiar with Jerron Baker?
Oh yes, honey.
Yeah. There you go again. That was your fault.
For about 6 months, honey.
6 months? Hold on. Y'all.
Keep calling him honey. He keep calling him honey. That's 5. After he just told him to do it again, he's steady, making his passes at him. And he accepting it. He honoring it. Why this?
Y'all was in the same cell for 6 months?
Oh, yes, girl.
So, hold on.
Six.
One more question. Then he had the top.
Oh, yes, girl. The homosexual keep calling him girlfriend and girl. That's a man, though. He just called him, yes, girlfriend. Look. He's imposing himself. Listen.
Oh, yes, honey. Yes, honey. He was my cellmate for about 6 months, honey.
6 months? Hold on. So y'all was in the cell, in the same cell for 6 months?
Oh, yes, girl.
Oh, yes, girl. See that? And he answered to it. She just said yes, girl, to him. And she answered, oh, such an adorable little doll.
Hold on, one more question. Did he have the top bunk or the bottom bunk?
Oh, he was the bottom.
Oh, no. Wait. Whoa. Pause. I said, I'm talking about the bands, the bunk bands. Did he have the top band or on the bottom band, King?
I was more of the top, honey, but, you know, we would switch it up sometimes.
Oh, wow. Hey, yo, I got a question, you know what I'm saying? I know you're doing, you know what I'm saying, a little time and all that, you know what I'm saying? Just for confirmation, you know what I'm saying, what was your name again, sir, miss?
My name is Cinnamon Toast, honey.
Cinnamon Toast?
7. That's 7 times. Now he asked the trainee name. The trainee say, my name is Cinnamon Toast, honey. Call him honey again. That's 7 times. Now that's 7. Called him girlfriend 3 times, honey 4 times. That's 7 times. Watch this.
Cinnamon crunchy,
dear, crunchy. Hey, yo, I ain't never crunchy. Watch your mouth, you heard? You know what I'm saying? But I want.
See that?
Right. I got a question to ask you. Now I'm saying before we get to Jerome Baker, now I'm saying, why they call you Cinnamon Toast Crunch? Now I'm saying, if it's some porn's worthy shit, don't say it, Jerry. I'm trying to monetize.
Because I'm sweet, honey. That's
oh, because you're sweet. All right, that answers everything.
Hey, notice he keep calling him honey.
That answers everything. You know what I'm saying? All right, so I don't know if you're familiar, you know what I'm saying, with Jerome Baker. You know what I'm saying? His current activities outside, you know what I'm saying, on the streets here, free man and all that. You know what I'm saying? Outside in a free world, you know what I'm saying, Jerome Baker is also known as Battle Truth. You know what I'm saying? He's a battle rap blogger. You know what I'm saying? Right now, you know what I'm saying, he had a little story about you back in the day saying, yeah, I had a little thing back in the cell and all that. You know what I'm saying? You're trying to clear some things up. You know what I'm saying? You want to speak on that? Hold on, so he's beating you?
Yeah, sometimes he would beat me, honey, but, you know, I'm a tough boy.
You a tough
boy? Sometimes I would beat him, but he a tough boy.
Boy.
Very tough, honey.
Hey, yo, and I'm saying, so hold on. So you're trying to tell me right now, you confirming right now, Battle Tune Cellmate, a.k.a. Cinnamon Toast Crunch, a.k.a. Cinnamon Toast Crunchy, if you're feeling crunchy, and I'm saying, you're trying to confirm right now that all those stories is true, and I'm saying that you actually had, and I'm saying, a little oral agreement, and I'm saying, with Jerome Baker?
Yes, I did.
When I say oral agreement, I'm talking about, and I'm saying, the prison terms, yeah? Hey, yo. So hold on. You trying to say Battle Goof was in a part of cell? Jerome Baker was in a cell with you for 6 months and you turned him out?
He turned me out.
Right? He turned. Oh, wait.
Listen, that. See, okay, now listen to this. So he getting turned on by fantasizing about something that's not true, seeing no problem with it. Homosexual keep on flirting with him throughout the whole thing. He's sitting up here asking him these questions that he's making up in his head, and yet he still don't get what's happening to him. Now notice what he asked me. Notice what he asked him. He says, have we ever had any type of relations? So the dude, y'all already know this false. I don't even know why I'm even going through this. I'm just proving how fake this is. So the dude says, oh, we had many hot nights. Then he said, like, what do you mean? Any oral agreement? He like, oral, anal, you name it, right? Then he like, did he turn you out? He said, yeah. I turned him out. Listen at this. I want to show you something.
So, Jerome Baker was in a cell with you for 6 months, and you turned him out?
And you turned him out. See that? And did you turn me out? Watch this. Did the homosexual turn me out? Watch the homosexual answer.
He turned me out.
He turned... Oh, wait.
Look, did you turn him out? Then the homosexual say, no, he turned me out, honey. Watch this.
Wait. So you trying to tell me before you went in the cell you was a straight man?
Get back. I'm on the phone. Hello?
See, now that really messed up everything. Whoever he talking to in his real home just messed up the interview to show that it's not prison. So somebody must have heard him talking and thought he may be talking to somebody else. So that just threw the whole conversation off to prove it's not even a prison call. But watch this.
Oh, damn. Who that? That was your cellmate?
Yes, I did. Go ahead, ask me your question.
Look, he had to catch himself. He was just finna tell who it really was. And he like, who that, your cellmate? Because he trying to put him back on because he know it just messed up the end. It just messed up this thing he faking. So he had to put him back in character. He said, who is that? Your cellmate? But the homosexual was finna tell him who it really was because they know each other personally. Then he like he stalled and said, get back to your question. See what I'm saying? Watch this. Pay attention. Y'all got to pay attention to the game. Pay attention.
And the cellmate was a straight man?
Get back. I'm on the phone. Hello?
Oh, damn. Who that? The cellmate?
No, that's Yes, Ronnie. Go ahead, ask me your question.
See how you had to think? See how you had to think?
I said before you got before you went into jail, you was a straight man.
Yeah, I was straight. I had a wife before I went to prison and
marriage. Met Gerard. Whoa, slow down. Whoa, slow down. Time out. You just threw me through a loop. No J2, now I'm saying no pause. You trying to say you was a straight man before you went to jail? And as soon as you went to jail in 6 months, Jerron Baker turned you out?
Yeah,
hey, yo! Go ahead.
Pay attention to that. He was a straight man before he went to jail. Then I turned him out. Watch this.
Yeah, right now you talking about he a Christian and all that. And I'm saying, was he preaching to God? And I'm saying, why he was in there? Or was he Muslim?
Oh, no.
So what was he praising? And I'm saying, I know when niggas go to jail and all that. And I'm saying, he turned Muslim and all that. And I'm saying,
this dude is really corny. He boring as hell, man. This dude is boring and corny as hell, man. Somebody really made him think he actually funny. Look, even when I've been in many blogging wars with people, and sometimes I'd be like, oh, now that was funny. Even when they say things against me, depending on, I'd be like, oh, now that was funny. That was funny. This dude ain't nowhere near funny, man. He's so corny. He boring as hell. But come on, man.
What was he praising to?
Only thing he
praised
to was me, honey.
Hey, yo. On his knees? Hey, yo. And you giving up. Now I'm saying a lot of information and all that. Now I'm saying I got one more question before you go and all that. Now I'm saying
the only one I was praising was him.
Now I'm saying while Battle Goof was in jail, while Jerron Baker was in jail and all that. Now I'm saying for 6 months. Now I'm saying what type of cellmate was he? Now I'm saying was he the type to wash the drawers and all that? Now I'm saying or was he the tough guy?
Oh, he was a cupcake, honey.
He was a cupcake. Oh, he is very sweet.
Now he asked him what type of guy I was. Let me just show you how fake that is. What type of guy I was when I was in prison? Was I a tough guy? Was I soft? The homosexual says I was a cupcake. I was a cupcake. I was real sweet. Wait, but I'm supposed to have been the one that turned you out. You was a straight man before you went to prison, only to come to prison and get turned out by me, who's a cupcake and a softie. So what do that say about a straight man who never was a homosexual until he met me, got turned out by a sweetie pie, a cupcake who's soft? So what would that make him? See how weak these people are? These people are weak, boy, I'm telling you.
You say he was sweet?
Very sweet, very nice man.
Damn. Now I'm saying I don't want to hold you up too long and all that. Now I'm saying I know you got a little you want to box and all that. Now I'm saying you're doing 23-1 and all that. Now I'm saying you got a little hour of free time and all that. I don't want to hold you up. You heard?
No, thank you, honey.
I appreciate your time. I hear you. My bad. Go ahead.
Thank you,
being I appreciate your time and all that. Now I'm saying you heard, sis. All right, get back. I'm gonna tell Jerron to hit up your commissary, you heard?
Thank you, honey.
All right. Cinnamon rolls and all that, you heard?
This dude is a straight up sucker. The homosexual all throughout this fake interview keep calling him honey and girlfriend. He's answering to him with total respect. Now, what straight man, a person, would allow a homosexual man to keep calling him girlfriend? Girlfriend. And he keep on honoring him. Listen to him keep calling him girlfriend. Watch this. Listen.
Then you got a little hour of free time and all that. I don't want to hold you up, you heard?
Thank you, honey.
I appreciate your time. I hear you. My bad. Go ahead.
Thank you, DNA's truth.
I appreciate your time and all that. And I'm saying, you heard, sis?
Yep,
yep,
man. I'll talk to you later. Thank you.
Yes, girlfriend. He called him girlfriend through the whole thing. And he trying to make it seem as though I'm gay. When this is a whole lie. This is a personal friend he know personally that keep calling him girlfriend, keep calling him honey. Watch this though.
Thank you.
All right, get back. I'm gonna tell Gerard to hit up your commissary, you heard?
Thank you, honey.
All right. Cinnamon rolls and all that, you heard?
You're not funny at all.
All right, I'm saying, y'all heard it right there. Know what I'm saying? Shout out to Cinnamon Toast, know what I'm saying? And Cinnamon, aka Cinnamon Toast Crunch, know what I'm saying? She said if you crunchy, pause, know what I'm saying? That right there, know what I'm saying, was a whole J2 conversation and all that, know what I'm saying? Part himself, I ain't know what's gonna go down like that.
You orchestrated, you knew it was gonna go down like that. You the one led them on. What are you talking about? You the one put this whole thing together. So watch this, y'all.
I ain't know what's gonna go down like that, y'all.
You definitely did.
Damn. Oh my God, I gotta light up. That was crazy. I gotta light up. Hold on, y'all. Yo, T-Boom, hold on the chat, T-Boom. Cash App, down inside DNA Tooth, y'all. Hold on, y'all. Damn.
This dude a clown.
He said Cinnamon Tooth's Crunch.
And he not funny at all. He boring as hell. Soon I hit it one part, I'm about to light this clown up. This dude is terrible, man. But this what happened when y'all let people y'all let people come in. Look, he even sound like a girl. Look.
That shit was saying.
What man sound like that?
Rolfing. Woo! Rick Flynn, nigga. Damn, that shit was saying.
What man hear octaves like that? What man hear all them octaves like that?
Damn. All right, we back. Yo, Scotty, beam me back down. Beam me back down, Scotty. All right, I'm back. Peanut butter. And yo, peanut butter, what did you just hear that phone call, peanut butter? Now I'm saying breaking news, y'all. Now I'm saying Battle Goose Cellmate, now I'm saying had just came forward, now I'm saying admitted to all the homosexual activities, now I'm saying that was going on with, now I'm saying with Gerard Baker, aka Battle Goose, and the cellmate, y'all. Now I'm saying Cinnamon Toast Crunch, y'all. Y'all heard that? Damn, y'all.
That's another thing. You ain't gonna never, ever get no homosexual, no man ever coming out saying we did anything together. Not gonna happen. Sorry. It's not gonna happen. No matter how hard you try, you're gonna have to make up stuff like this. That ain't gonna never happen. Ever gonna happen. Sorry, brother. That's another reason how you know this stuff is false and it's fake. If it was true, forget third parties. Why they don't come forward themselves? If you notice, they always try to use third parties. Sunset said this. Well, where they at? Why you can never get the real people to come forward? Where are these homosexuals? Where they at? Where are these homosexuals and victims at? Where they at? You will never get them. Not when it comes to me. You get what I'm saying? So it's easy to expose these clowns. But watch this, though.
Mutual Johnson said, Battle Goof had very hot nights. According to Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Goddamn, y'all. Know what I'm saying? I feel uncomfortable. Know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie. I feel uncomfortable. Know what I'm saying? I'm gonna have to take a cold shower after this. Know what I'm saying?
He feel uncomfortable. He's going to have to take a cold shower after this. Mm-hmm.
All right, know what I'm saying? Y'all heard it right there. Know what I'm saying? Shout out to Cinnamon Toast. Know what I'm saying? And Cinnamon, aka Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Know what I'm saying? She said if you crunchy, pause. Know what I'm saying? That right there, know what I'm saying, was a whole J2 conversation and all that. Know what I'm saying? Part himself. I ain't know what's gonna go down like that. I ain't always gonna go down like that, Joe. My bad. Damn. Oh my God, I gotta light up. I got that was crazy. I gotta light up. Hold on, yo. Yo, T Boom. Hold on the chat, T Boom. Cash App, $DNA2, yo. Hold on, yo. Damn. Nigga said cinnamon toast crunch. If you're feeling crunchy, what? God damn. That shit was hitting. Yeah, Rolfing. Woo! Rick Flynn, nigga. Damn, that shit was hitting. Hold on. Woo! Damn. Alright, we back. Yo, Scotty, beat me back down. Beat me back down, Scotty. Alright, I'm back. Peanut butter. And peanut butter, did you just hear that phone call, peanut butter? Now I'm saying breaking news, y'all. Now I'm saying Battle Goose Cellmate, now I'm saying that just came forward, now I'm saying admitted to all the homosexual activities, now I'm saying that was going on with, now I'm saying with Gerard Baker, aka Battle Goose, and the cellmate, y'all. Now I'm saying Cinnamon Toast Crunch, y'all. Y'all heard that? God damn, y'all. Mutual Johnson said, Battle Goof had very hot nights, according to Cinnamon Toast Crunch. God damn, y'all. Know what I'm saying? I feel uncomfortable. Know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie. I feel uncomfortable. Know what I'm saying? I'm gonna have to take a cold shower after this. Know what I'm saying? I don't want to have no memories, no bad dreams and all that. Know what I'm saying? That was very uncomfortable. Know what I'm saying? Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Know what I'm saying? That was uncomfortable, Cinnamon. Hold on. MVP said, Battle Goof was born gay? What? Young Non Slim said Battle Truth likes guys and his own kids. Damn, you took it there. Damn. J Doom said, damn, Battle Goof need to address this ASAP. He gonna try to hide it. He gonna try to avoid it. He gonna try to avoid it, make up a whole story. Yo, he's lying. That's not true. The nigga called me. He called me. Y'all was him. Y'all heard it, right? Battle Goof cellmate just confirmed. Now I'm saying all them homosexual activities. Now I'm saying that Battle Truth was talking about. Now I'm saying, but hold on. If y'all ain't hear it, now I'm saying, let me remind it. Hold on, y'all. Speedy, what's the word? Jiggy Jam. The booty gone? Hey, yo, Pons. Hold on, let's run it back. Yeah, hold on.
Blue, Magneto, hold this down for me because I got a call from prison I got to take right now.
Yeah, I'm calling prison. He just called me too, Banagul.
That's.
Hold on, Banagul said he got a call from prison. That's the kind of calls you be getting, Banagul? Is that the kind of calls you be getting? God damn, y'all. Weird and all that. Now I'm saying I ain't had what? I ain't never had no goddamn thoughts like that in my head. What? Now I'm saying I went to jail. Now I'm saying I was locked up in an aura jail. That was a bomb. It was a reach. Aura jail. And y'all, yeah, said deleted game need to come back for real, for real. Mr. Johnson said, "Battle Truth, the back." And Alex Wild in the comments, who got shot? Christian Johnson, R.I.P. Moment of silence for Christian Johnson. I don't know what you're saying. Now I'm saying I ain't even ever seen a name before. Now I'm saying, but R.I.P. to Christian Johnson. Moment of silence. All right, now I'm saying, watch your mouth, Christian Johnson. I don't know what you're saying. I ain't catch it. Now I'm saying, but that's don't got a shooter in here. That's why I got a couple shooters in here, huh? Oz said, I just seen a crazy title. Yo, Oz, yo, OZ, OZ, Oz. Now I'm saying, we got QP, now we got ounce. It ain't ounce, half an ounce. You missed the ounce. Now I'm saying, battle goof, cellmate, we're just on the line and all that. Now I'm saying, replay it, you hear it? Now I'm saying, he confirmed, he indeed confirmed, or should I say she? Confirmed, I'm saying. Bad group was out there, and I'm saying, doing some extracurricular activities, and I'm saying with the cellmate, you heard? Spooky. Nasty work. R.I.P. to California. Damn, Southern Cal. Southern Cal. It's always hot in Southern Cal, and I'm saying, but ARES always keeps something hot on him. ARES always keeps something hot, man. R.I.P. Jay Doom said, Toop, I need an interview. Cash App, dollar sign, DNA, Toop, you heard? Social World Peace, Mr. Word King. Now I'm saying, well, hold on, let me ask y'all before I get up out of here. What do y'all think about, now I'm saying, Battle Goof, cellmate, now I'm saying, coming forward, now I'm saying, admitting, now I'm saying, that all them dreams that Battle Goof said he was having, now I'm saying, it was a reality. It was a reality thing. Jay Doom, you got clap? Nigga just asked for an interview. Damn. Now I'm saying, what do y'all think about that, y'all? Let me ask y'all. Let me light up. Whoa! Damn. Charles Finley said, how I get merch? Hit me up on the DM. And I'm saying IG. And I'm saying at DNA underscore Toop and all that. And I'm saying holler at me on Twitter at King DNA Toop. And I'm saying hit my email. And I'm saying DNAToop1@gmail.com. You heard? Peanut butter. What's the word, peanut butter? Make sure y'all follow peanut butter on Instagram and all that. Yo, peanut butter, drop your IG. Yo, Jeff Ford, salute you, heard? North Philly, salute. Shout out to North Philly. Now I'm saying all the young bulls. Now I'm saying all the old hands. Now I'm saying all the niggas that be dick eating. Pawns. I know I'm saying Tooth was a tame. YG said walk on thin ice in here. Hold on. You walking on thin ice right now, YG? Thin ice? I think your ice about to break right now, YG. Yo, I think it's ice about to break, T-Bone. What you think, T-Bone? And y'all, what you think? Peanut butter, what you think? What you think? You think that ice looking a little thin right there? He walking on thin ice. Bang, oh shit. Nigga fell through the ice. He fell through the ice. Ah! Ah! Yo, nigga fell through the ice. Yo, that shit was slippery, King. Nigga say you walking on thin ice. Like, damn, King. Damn, King. You better learn how to swim. You better learn how to swim. I hope the water ain't cold. I hope the water ain't cold. Yo, Smith side, on South side, what's the word? Damn, South side got clapped. I just said what up to him. Damn. Damn. Nigga say, I don't care. Yo, Anthony Tony. Nigga with the two first names. What's the word, King? You know what I'm saying? I'm about to get up out of here and all that. You know what I'm saying? Cash App, dollar sign, DNA, Tooth, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Get Battle Goof cellmate. You know what I'm saying? Just came forward and all that. You know what I'm saying? In a minute. You know what I'm saying? That Battle Goof's dreams was actually reality, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Battle Goof, you know what I'm saying? Is living a double life. You know what I'm saying? He's a double agent, y'all. He's a double agent. Nigga living a double life, y'all. He's a double agent. Double on. Double on. Double on. Double on. Now I'm saying Babel Goof is a double agent, y'all. Now I'm saying he working for the other team, y'all. He working for the other side. Now I'm saying he wanna come over here, and I'm saying play hide and seek. Oh, I hope they didn't notice. I wear this stocking cap on my hand, and I'm saying it's really a bonnet. I hope they don't notice. I hope they don't notice. I talk with a lisp. I hope they don't notice. We notice. Now I'm saying, like a battle group, I'm saying, stop saying my name, battle group. Now I'm saying, this is not it. Listen up. Yo, Vic P. Salute, Vic P. I'm Penny. Listen up. The finesse kid, listen up. This is not the end. Y'all hear me? Banner Goof, say my name again. Say my name like 2022. I'm laying down the law in 2022. Shit different now. It's different now, you heard? No more Mr. Nice Tooth. No more Mr. Nice Tooth, you heard? I've been playing around with y'all niggas, not responding. And I'm seeing like y'all niggas walk all over the tooth and all that. No more. Say my name one more time. I dare you. Say it with me, y'all. I dare you. You thought your cellmate? You thought that was bad? You thought that was bad, Battle Goof? Huh? I dare you. I dare you. I dare you. I dare you. Yo, Vic P. I dare you. Lucio Johnson. I dare you. T-Boom. I dare you. It's VIP. I dare you. Jiggy Jam. I dare you. Spinny. I dare you. Mikey the Man. I dare. Big Unk. I. Jeff Ford. I. Malfunction. Malfunction overload. System rebooted. I dare you. I Penny. I dare you. SVIP. I dare you. ALES. I dare you. Anthony Tony. I dare you. Big Out TV. I dare you. ALES. I dare you. Speedy. I dare. System overloaded. I dare you. Damn, Speedy got clapped. Speedy, you got clapped. My bad, I was shut down. Damn, you got clapped, man. Bing. And shout out to the people, y'all. Cash App, Dollar Sign, DNA Tooth, y'all. And I'm saying, tell Battle Goof, I dare you. And I'm saying, yo, Aeon, Ratchet, Peanut Butter. Damn, niggas can clap. T-Boom. Y'all ready? Y'all ready? Clap all the witnesses
right now. Clap all the witnesses right now. Clap everybody right now. All the witnesses getting shot. All the witnesses getting shot. We out. Leave no witnesses. All bodies. There we go. Pow. Let the bodies pound. Let the bodies pound. I ain't see nothing. Melee TV still. I see Melee. How many? Melee TV. Is he dead, kid? Is he dead, kid? Vic P, clap that nigga. Oh, shit. Everybody dead? Shit looking like one more thing out here. I'm out. God damn.
Here, take it. Bang the gavel on your damn self. Don't worry, I'm gonna do it for you. No. Did he just say he gonna have to take a cold shower after this? You were turned on by this? That's what people do when they have to take a cold shower after hearing sexual things to turn them off because they've been turned on. That's the reason why people say they need to take a cold shower after hearing something hot or sexual because they were turned on and need to be turned off. The cold water takes away the desire that you're feeling, your arousement that's going on within you as a result of what you just experienced. So you talking to this homosexual that's a friend of yours who kept calling you honey and girlfriend, describing oral sex and anal sex, got you feeling some type of way that you have to take a cold shower? Here, take it. Bang the gavel on your damn self. Yeah. You expose yourself, didn't you? Yep. No. Terrible. You started out trying to make this blog all about me, but it became all about you, exposing you. I know I don't know the chump, but you know him very well. In so much as he was making passes at you through this whole thing. You know his phone number, he got your phone number. What y'all be talking about? What's this all about? What you turned on for about this? Oh, now I get it. Dwayne Parks. So you like for niggas to pull up in back of you and empty their trunks out on you. That's what you like, Dwayne Parks? Yeah, that's who DNA 2 feels. His true identity is Dwayne Parks. So Dwayne Parks, a.k.a. DNA 2, he got his name from niggas pulling up behind him, emptying out their trunks inside of him. This dude is a real glory boy. This dude is a real fairy. No wonder you done built your whole image around a doll. Around a doll. Not only a doll, but a doll that got to do with oral. Giving head. Oh, so you pull the teeth out to give better head. Oh, now it makes sense. Now I get the acronym DNA tooth. That stands for deep throating niggas aggressively with no tooth. So that's what you like to do. So you snatch out your damn tooth so that you can aggressively deep throat niggas. Do you deep throat them so deep that you touch the lap? Do you, Dwayne, deep throat them so deep that you actually can kiss his lap? This is a straight up fruitcake. Oh yeah. We're going to talk about it today. This is a straight up fruitcake. You didn't put your spirit in a doll who you stick your hand up his ass and you pretend to talk for him because you used to finger popping yourself. So let me get this right. You ball your hand up like a damn Marvel comic and you bounce on it. And you bounce on it to the point that you can throw your voice like a damn ventriloquist because you like niggas pulling up behind you. Huh? That's what this is about? Oh my God. Look. You out of your league, partner. You out of your league. This is uncharted territory that you should never cross because you don't stand a chance in this league right here, partner. Okay? First of all, let's get one thing straight about you two. Everybody know you are a bona fide coward. Everybody know that. And it's even more shameful that this doll who you portraying as an image is more important than you are. Did you not know that? Do you know that this doll is more important than you are? That if you were to get on the camera and show your face, you are no relevant to the community at all? So now you have to forever be a doll because your real face is not even important. It's not even accepted. Do you not get this? Do you also not get how much of a sucker nigga you is? That you could actually call up a homosexual friend of yours, rehearse something that's not true, then be aroused and turned on about it, that you got to take a cold shower to calm down because you was aroused by it. Exposing yourself. Exposing yourself. And yet you sit here and try to talk about everybody in battle rap when your life is worse than everybody's in battle rap. You trying to use battle rap for a thing to make money. That's why you always cash out me, cash out me. Oh, get some of this merchandise. Really? That's another thing about you. You tried to buy your way into battle rap. How many battle rappers you paid to do drops for you? How many battle rappers you paid to wear your clothes? Ain't nobody buying that trash. Ain't nobody wearing that weak stuff. But guess what you did? You paying people so that you can have a position here. You paid to get in the community. That's what you did. You've been a battle true flunky since you've been here. You forgot we got the profiles. You forgot we got the tapes. You forgot we got all this. We got you inside the comments begging to come on my channel and platform. We got you talking about how good I am in battle rap. We got that. We got that. Now you think you're feeling yourself because you just started to get noticed? You'll forever be up under me, chump. You're a sorry, pathetic nigga. You're a coward. That's how you know you a sucker. You can't show your face because now you're going to get punched on by everybody. Ain't that right? Let's tell the real truth. Let's break down your dog. You can't show your face because you're going to get beat up. Everybody know that. You do know that, right? You do know that. But this how much of a fake, fraudulent nigga you is. So because you can't show your face, you figure you got the green light to just talk about people and disrespect people because they don't know who you are. Guess what, Dwayne Parts? Now they do know who you are, okay? Now they do know who you are. You're a straight-up sucker, weak nigga, man. And you've been exposed on being a homosexual. We know that this is true, too. We found out some more things about you. Bro, you out of your league. We found out some more stuff about you. So let me get this right. You done called up your homosexual lover on the phone to try to perpetrate like they know me, but in reality, they know you. And for what I'm hearing, y'all have sex to the point y'all get stuck together like canines. Like literally. You know how dogs have sex and then after sex, they stuck together? That's what they said these fairy boys be doing. This Dwayne Parks let the tranny park up beside him and then they get stuck. They get stuck when the tranny is unloading up inside him. They stuck like Elmer Glue. They stuck to the side like a damn German shepherds. They stuck to the side like German shepherds, like Siamese twins, and got to put water on them to loosen them up. That's how they always get caught. That's how he ended up getting caught with his other homosexual lover. They were stuck together. After they were finished having sex, they were stuck together. So when the other tranny lover came over and caught them, they were stuck and couldn't get apart. He couldn't lie about it. The tranny was still stuck up in them. Having bestiality sex. Dog, you was a loser. You're a straight up loser, dog. How dare you think that you can stand anywhere near me on any level. Did you see how I can roast you without even roasting your whole person, the real person you are? You ashamed, dude. You ashamed. Let's talk about some more things. So you paid your way to be in a community. This is how much of a loser you is. So you paid your way to be in a community. Yeah, everybody know. You paying everybody to do drops. You paying everybody to wear your clothes. You paying everybody to say, hey, he nice. When in reality, that wasn't true. It wasn't honest. You ain't like, I don't do that type of stuff. You see the difference between you and I? You had to pay to get here. You had to pay to be here. I didn't. I'm the people champ. I was elected. You see what I'm saying? Don't get to let me run down my accolade because you couldn't handle it. You ain't never made the Source magazine the first year you was here. I did. You don't have NBA players coming out validating who you are, stars validating who you are, without having to ask them, without even knowing it. What drops you on? Are you on any league drops? Are you on any URL drops? Are you on any RBE drops? Are you on any King of the Dot drops? Are you on any of these drops? I am. How about that? I am. I'm on every league drops. Are you mentioned more in battles than I am? Doubt it. No, you not. Are you spoke more about in battle rap than me? No, you not. Do you have more followers and supporters than me? No, you not. No, you don't. Do you have more views than me? No, you don't. What are you talking about? You out of your league, partner, and you talking to the wrong one. You a fake nigga. You not even original. Come up with something of your own. Stop trying to remake everybody else's stuff that did it before you and failed in that also. You using stuff that people already failed in. How you going to be effective? How you going to be effective? You just lost this one again. Now you down 0-2. You will never get a round off on me, partner, because you a fake nigga. Everybody know that. You an unimportant nigga in this community. You bought your way in. You bought your way in, partner. Nobody validated you on their own. You paid for niggas to say shots out to you. Who don't know that? Everybody know that. I don't have to do that. I got a track record of people showing me love. See the difference? Battle goof. Nigga, I'm smarter than you could ever be. You just exposed yourself trying to expose me. You just really showed that you was the one that's the fairy boy. You the one that's the cupcake. You the one that's getting Roman sex. You the one that snatched out your damn teeth so that you could give aggressive head. So that's why your name DNA Tooth. Because niggas leave their DNA in your mouth. Niggas done left their DNA in your mouth, and you sitting up here trying to stun on people when you live a sour life. This dude having a real conversation with a homosexual friend of his that's a close associate of him, and then he get hard and turned on in the middle of the conversation that he got to take a cold shower. And listen to this sucker. Listen at this sucker nigga. Look what he just said. Look at this sucker nigga.
Y'all Baker, a.k.a. Bad Goof, and his cellmate, y'all. Now I'm saying Cinnamon Toast Crunch, y'all. Y'all heard that? Y'all heard that? God damn, y'all. Lucho Johnson said, Battle Goof had very hot nights. According to Cinnamon Toast Crunch. According to Cinnamon Toast Crunch. God damn, y'all. Know what I'm saying? I feel uncomfortable. Know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie. I feel uncomfortable. Know what I'm saying? I'm gonna have to take a cold shower after this. Know what I'm saying?
You got to take a cold shower. That's what that means. You can't change that up. Can't change that up. We heard the audio, the homosexual calling you girlfriend throughout the whole conversation. You keep answering him in respectful. You didn't even turn it down. He calling you girlfriend, you answering him. He calling you girlfriend over and over again, and you answering him. Here, man. Here. Take it. No. Why he wasn't offended in that, y'all? Why wasn't he offended and the homosexual keep calling him girlfriend? Why he wasn't offended in that? Why he wasn't offended and his homosexual keep calling him honey over and over again? And don't try to throw him no lightsaber by saying, like, no, they set that up like that. And that's even more shameful, ain't it? That you set this up like that to be called that, knowing that you supposed to not be that. So again, why are you so comfortable with that? Why was you accepting that? Why was you receiving it? Huh? Why was you receiving that? Why that didn't bother you? Because that's what he is, y'all. That's what he is. This is a fake nigga. You know it because he chose to be a dog rather than showing his face. And you know why he can't show his face? Because he ratted on too many niggas. He backstabbed too many niggas. He don't want people to see who he really is because guess what? They're going to be like, man, that nigga, like, nigga, that's you? So that was you all alone on his Kenny Lewis type stuff. That was you all alone all the time. And that was you? Yeah. Look at Dwayne Parks, y'all. Yeah, that's him. That's him, a straight up loser. You know they got video clips of you getting your booty fondled with, right? Yeah, this is real facts, y'all. This is real live facts. They got a video of him literally getting his booty played with. So all this stuff makes sense now, Mr. Parks. All this stuff makes sense now. Your homosexual friend calling you girlfriend, calling you honey. You on hard, you got to take a shower to calm down. And all along, you've been getting your booty played with. Now, this ain't no lie, is it? Is it, Mr. Parks? Am I lying? No matter how entertaining it sounds, am I lying? Do you want to put some money up that we got a video of you actually getting your butt touched? Put some money on that. You want to put some money on that? Let's do it. Let's do it, Mr. Dwayne Parks, that we can produce a video with Dwayne Parks getting his booty touched by another man. Put some money on it. I'm willing. Take me up on my challenge. See the difference between you and I? Nigga, these little things you using, that stuff don't affect me. Everybody who did it before you failed in it, and so are you. What you gonna remix everybody's stuff? Do it. You're still gonna come up short like you're doing now. When it's real, it's real, boy. Don't you get this? Don't you get this? You out of your league, clown. You a disappointment to yourself. Everything about you show you a battle-true flunky. Look at your little DNA tooth thing trying to wear a rag like me. Where that come from, partner? Where that come from? Don't forget, before you so-called was popping, you was all in my comments. You was all in my lives. You was calling up on my platform. Let's not forget this. Let's not forget this. You was a fan of mine before you even created this image of this doll you put your spirit in to live out your homosexual fantasies. Let's not forget that. These are truths that you can't get around. Act said ain't so. Yeah, we know what's up. Yeah, you out of your league, partner. I'm freestyling on you. I'm freestyling on you, nigga. You a sorry dude, man. You a lame. Ain't nothing real about you at all. You a sucker, nigga. That's why your name is DNA too. Because you want a sucker, nigga. We just seen that. This dude called up his real lover on the phone. Like his real lover. And look how they sell this stuff. Then you know another thing this clown doing? This clown literally sitting up here. Have you noticed the people that's actually supporting Unbiased got all these things going on with them that freaky and suspect like this? Have y'all noticed this? Y'all ain't catching this? I'm catching it real clear. I'm catching it real clear. No coincidence. This ain't no coincidence. Now what's real? Y'all heard it. Look, I ain't had to change none of the audio like he did. They'll never play my audio popping that real truth. They just try to play a clip and then they switch it and edit it and put their little twist in. They don't let it play because they know I'm popping real stuff. I'm popping the truth. I didn't play with this videotape. I let it play and y'all heard it out of their own mouth. All I was pushing was pause, play, and you heard all through it. This dude is a sucker, man. This dude is a sucker and he's a fairy boy. He's pixie dust. That's exactly who he is. He a real fairy in real life, apart from the doll. Apart from the doll. This is how he is in his real life. Y'all know this dude a coward. You know you a coward. How could you respect a man who try to say something about everybody in battle rap but ain't real enough to show his face? That's a coward. That's a guy. That shows you, not only is he a coward, that shows he a snake and he a rat because he have betrayed people in his inner circle. That's what that means. That's why he scared to show his face. That's why he can't show his face because he already backstabbed the snake niggas in his inner circle. That's why. But you know he a clown. You know he a fraud. You know he a fake because he don't mind other people being hurt as a result of them being mistaken as him. That's another reason how you know he a fake nigga. He won't even help nobody. He will let people go down. This how much of a coward and a fraud and a snake this fake nigga is. He know people being accused of being him, that's not even him. He see it and he watch it. He will let them get hurt knowing that that's not even him. He will let them get hurt knowing that that's not him. He won't even cut in. Like when they was having that big thing on Faces where the AR-16 dude and No Bars and somebody else was supposed to bend him. And guys was getting heated behind it because they know what's going to happen when he found out. He was listening to all that. He wasn't trying to help nobody. He wasn't trying to clear nobody's name up. He would rather for them to get hurt for him. He would rather for them to go down for him. But it won't stop him from keep lying on people. It won't stop him from keep trying to tear people down. It ain't gonna stop him from doing that. That's how you know he a fake nigga. And I get it what entertainment is. But this is the thing I don't respect and why I never rock with this nigga. Let me tell you something. If you're going to be in a community like this and you're going to be talking about people, then you should be real enough to show your damn face. You can always go back to the puppet. You can always go back to the damn puppet. No, I ain't going to even call it a puppet. It's a doll. That's what you're doing. You're playing with a damn doll, an overgrown man who got to wash up his pillow doll, brush the pillow doll, hug it and squeeze it and kiss it in the mouth. Because you's a sucker, nigga. You a sucker, nigga. You're 33 some years old and you worshiping this damn doll. But at the same time, you jealous of the doll. You worshiping the doll, but jealous of it at the same time because you can never be as popular as the doll. You do know if you remove the doll and show your face, your numbers go down, right? You do know that, right? Look at you. You can't even be successful with your own face. You should slap your damn self. Slap yourself, right, for being a useless nigga. What you got that's original? Even this teeth ain't even original. You stole it from DNA and you stole it from me. So you don't even get credit for that. You a sucker, nigga. Ain't that something? You see how I could just read you your rights? You see how I could just call you out like that? And again, I'm just practicing. This ain't nothing. This ain't nothing. This you light work. Out of all the people I ever had blogging wars with, you the lightest. Nigga, you the lightest. This is weak. This ain't nothing. This ain't nothing. I don't have to see your face to break you down because I know the man who behind the doll is a sucker, nigga. I know you're a coward. You a sucker. You ain't real enough to tell God to their face how you feel. You don't want nobody to see your face. Why are you scared to show people your face? You can always go back to the doll. I'm going to make you show your face, coward. How about that? I'm going to make you show your face. You know how I'm going to make you show your face? By destroying the doll. I'm going to destroy what you worship. Since you worship this doll, I'm going to destroy that doll to the point that I make you show your face. Because every time somebody see the doll, now what's going to raise up in question? If the faggot behind them. That's you. That's you. Can you prove you not? Because we just proved you are. We got you on record saying you were just turned on by homosexual conversation or something and getting angle, and it turned you on that you need to take a cold shower. We got you recorded saying that. We got you recorded of the homosexual calling you girlfriend over and over again, and you responding to him politely, with humility, loving, and kind. We got that recorded. We got this recorded of this homosexual that you know personally, privately, who called you up on the phone and kept calling you honey. You can't get around that. You see how that stuff turned around and now it backfired on you? We got videotapes of you getting your booty felt on by another man and you didn't have no problem with it. Who you talking to? What you got to say about me? Huh? What you gonna say about me? What you gonna use against me? Nothing. Nigga, I make more money than you. Could you put up money? You want to go dollar for dollar? Can you do that? Let's do it. And I bet you lose that. I bet you lose that. I bet your house don't look better than mine. Let's do that. Let's do that. Since you want to talk, you want to show numbers, you want to show subscribers, let's do that. You're going to lose that. Where you going to win at? Where you going to win at? Who are you going to talk about? Huh? What, you going to lie? That ain't going to even help you. You can't get around paperwork. You can't get around witnesses. What do you have? What could you use? I destroy anything you put up. See, I just broke down your fake homosexual selling stuff that come out to be your real partner. Your real partner. What could you use? Who could you use? You have nothing. Nothing. I ain't near you. Right. Sound crazy. You don't even sound right. Did you think for once I wasn't going to entertain that? Nigga, who you talking to? You a sorry nigga. Simple as that. I don't have to tell you that because you know that already. That's another reason why you can't show your face, because you a sorry nigga. You don't even like your face so much that you believe your dial look better than you. That's how much you think of yourself. Ain't that something? You see, my brand becomes what it is because of this face. This mine's. This my face. This is who I am. Can you say that? Can you say that? No, you can't. You fade away. Just like everybody else. You corny. You not funny. You don't pop nothing real. All you do is repeat yourself over and over and over again. And you make a little weasel sound out of your mouth because you think that that's catchy. Dog, get up out of here, dog. You is weak. This is light work. Okay, this light work. This is, boy, please, I ain't even locked in on you yet. I just wanted to address and break. This ain't nothing, dog. This ain't nothing. Wait till I really lock in on you. But you know what? I don't even care about that. I honestly really don't even want to do it because I'm too talented for this. See, I got what you don't got. I got real talent. You clip and edit. I got real talent. I'm one of the only guys who can cut this camera on, and I don't have to do none of that, not keep people attention for as long as I choose, okay? Can you do that? No, you can't. You see all the gimmicks you need? These your daylight gimmicks. See that? These your daylight gimmicks. You like to do that type of stuff. How many of these devices you actually played with before presenting it on TV? How many? Did you answer that? You like toys. You like bringing toys in the room. You deep throw toys. You didn't deep throw the damn fire engine and had to call the fire department to dislodge a damn fire engine out your throat. That's how advanced this fairy boy is. This fairy boy so advanced because he done snatched out all his damn tooth to try to become the toothless guy who deep throat niggas aggressively with no tooth. He then pulled out all his damn tooth. And as a result of that, he go around sucking things. Sucking things. Well, since you like deep throating things, I got a question for you. Could you deep throat a damn mirror and slice your jaw? Could you deep throat a damn mirror and buck 50 yourself? Deep throw the damn mirror and buck 50 your face. Since you like deep throw thing and you just look dialed, I'm pretty sure you want some size on you. So could you climb on a giraffe back, deep throw this damn head, deep throw the giraffe's head till you reach his stomach? Could you deep throw the giraffe's head, since you like putting your mouth on stuff, since you like removing all your teeth so that you could be an aggressive sucker, since you love putting your mouth on things, since you love putting your mouth on things, do me this favor. I want you I want you to go to a park, right? And right by the sliding board, I want you to get up under the sliding board, and I want you to deep throat the damn sliding board up to the monkey bar. Could you deep throat the sliding board up to a monkey bar? You freak. You freak. DNA tooth. Deep throating niggas aggressively with no tooth. Without tooth. That's the acronym for DNA tooth now. Now when everybody see you, they gonna know that DNA tooth stands for deep throating niggas aggressively without tooth. Thank you for that acronym. Now get a damn Jack Boy main chain to go with it. Put it around that damn tooth. Since you like sucking stuff, I tell you what, suck the fan. I want you to climb on the ladder, cut on the damn fan, put your mouth on it, suck the damn fan, suck the damn ceiling fan till it slap the hell out you. Suck the ceiling fan. You sucker nigga, thinking he safe because he hide behind the dial. You ain't safe. You see, I can get at you even behind your damn, your dial with all your accessories to go with this damn dial. Where your finger popping accessory that come with this damn dial? Where the hand you could disattach from the damn dial? You jam up yourself like a damn traffic guard. Where this damn DNA tooth accessories like a Mr. Potato Head kit you like to suck on? That you had to get your damn stomach pumped. Well, how come your transgender friend, left a load in you? Dwayne Parks, let niggas pull up beside him and dump a load in them like they filling up for gas. You a sucker, nigga, man. Anyway, dude, you a lame dog. I'm just killing time with you, man. It's your boy Battle Truth. It ain't my judgment that's in question, it's yours. You down 0-2. You will never come back. You never come back. Anytime you do something, I'm going to do something better. And remember what I got. That the people ain't seen. Stay in your lane, dog. You out of your lane. You better keep talking to these battle rappers and league owners, bro. You out of your league. I ain't none of these dudes, man. I like your boy, please. You don't stand a chance, dog. Don't get me started. Now, go to your transgender lover and get...